Going forward, you're going to hear me say a certain acronym a lot. DOM. DOM, da-dom, dom, dom. DOM stands for Document Object Model. And it's the way that browsers let us developers manipulate web pages with JavaScript. Whenever a browser loads a web page, it parses all the HTML and CSS and converts the document into a DOM. That DOM is really a big JavaScript object that contains everything we'd ever want to know or change about a page, like every single tag and attribute and style for each tag. To access the DOM on a web page from JavaScript, we use the global variable document. And then we can use properties and call functions that are attached to this object here. The general strategy for DOM manipulation is two steps. Let me just make a list out of them here. Here we go, and then we have the second step. Let's go through each of these steps now. So the first step is to find the DOM node using an access method. If all we're looking for is the body tag, we can access that really easily just by saying document.body. And now the second step is to manipulate the DOM node that we found by changing its attributes, styles, inner HTML, appending new nodes to it. So if we just want to replace the contents of the whole tag, then we can use the inner HTML property. So document.body.inner HTML equals web page begone. Ta-da! I did it. The browser is watching for changes to the document object. And as soon as it sees you change the inner HTML of document.body, it reflects it back in the actual document. Remember, the document object isn't the actual web page, but the browser tries to make it reflect the current page as much as possible. Now, there are a lot more ways to do step one, because usually you want to find something besides just the body tag. Maybe you want to find a tag with a certain ID or all tags of a certain type. That's what we'll talk about in the DOM access methods tutorial. There's also a lot more cool stuff you can do in step two, like changing the attributes or styles of the tags you find. We'll talk about all that in the DOM modification tutorial. Once you've mastered DOM access and manipulation, we'll move on to fun ways to use it, like when responding to user events or making an animation. Right now, it is a little silly that we use JavaScript to do what we could have just done with HTML at the beginning, but trust me, you'll want to master DOM access and DOM modification so that you can make full interactive experiences later. So keep it up and see you soon.